Tiffany, passengers are starting to trickle out of the secured area. Remember how we can't go there anymore unless you're flying with a ticket. And we're hearing some interesting stories about what went on. I'm joined now by Megan Moffitt, and she's from Hartford, Connecticut, traveling with a bit of her family today. Megan, tell me when you knew something wasn't right.
Well, we boarded the plane. The elderly boarded first, and then we were heading on because they go by rows, and we're waiting in the gate to get on the plane, and then I saw the pilot come out, passed by everyone, looked a little cautious, and it came back through, and then they said on the announcement that everyone had to come back out. So that's when everyone started freaking out. What's going on? We want to know before we get back on the plane. So we're waiting for about half an hour before they tell us, and the fire trucks came and a dog sniffing. And then we heard people talking about there was a white powder on the plane, so they need to investigate. And everyone who was on the plane before, they may come out, walk down the stairs outside, and they're sitting out there still as of 2 hours now.
Now, Megan, your story is interesting because you're traveling with your mom, your dad, your grandfather, and your grandmother, but your grandmother is separated from you now. Tell us how that happened.
Well, she went on the plane first because she has a bad knee and she walks with a cane, so we let her on first. And so now she's sitting out there by herself. At least she has her cell phone so we can talk to her and make sure everything's okay. So now we're waiting to get back with her right now.
I could imagine. Thank God Grandma has a cell phone. We will continue to monitor this for you. They have not used, they're not using that gate B3 anymore throughout the evening, I've noticed. And we will stay on top of this one for you. Tiffany, back to you.